Well, you don't have to look far to find an Aussie poly behaving badly, but would docking their pay force them to behave better? That crackdown might just be about to happen.
For years, the centre of political power has been the centre of disturbing allegations of bullying and harassment, discrimination and assault. There seemed to be little consequence for bad behaviour, but that may soon change. New rules released, and not intentionally.
It wasn't our intention to have it out being publicly ventilated, but that's, you know, what's happened now.
The leaked document outlines the punishments for those who breach parliamentary standards, including politicians, staffers, lobbyists, journos, and really anyone who works in parliament. Politicians found to be in breach could be discharged from committees, suspended from parliament, and have up to 5% of their pay docked.
Until recently, people who worked in Parliament House for a politician didn't really have a HR. There was nowhere they could go to give any complaints or to ask for some sort of guidance or justice or even just to lodge a complaint about something that they were worried about or a behaviour that they weren't comfortable with.
The punishments were drafted by a cross-party task force that included Labor, Liberal, Nationals, Greens and Independents. Proposed rules for an independent parliamentary standards commission due to be established this October.
I think there has been a big change in the way this building operates. This is the final kind of piece of the puzzle in making sure we've got all the systems in place to make sure people are held to account for their behaviour.
But before any of this happens, before we get to enjoy the sight of misbehaving pollies searching the sofa for loose change or trying to remember their Bitcoin password, one group needs to sign off on it. The pollies themselves.
I think the parliamentarians won't have much choice but to pass laws that are going to punish themselves, and I'd pay very close attention to what people say in these debates and who votes against it. Because what is the point of voting against it? This is an independent body that's going to be investigating this. You can't blame politics for it. And if you haven't done anything wrong, well then, that's what the finding will be, that you haven't done anything wrong.
So are we on the verge of seeing Canberra culture become accountable?
You like this?
Happy? I don't mind most of it. Like, I think the idea of... If there's no HR mechanism, the idea of fining and things like that, I think that makes sense. The bit that bothers me a bit is the idea of suspending a politician from Parliament because we often forget they're not people turning up to do a job for their own benefit. They're people representing us. Yeah. So when you suspend someone from Parliament, you're not punishing them, you're punishing that everyone in that seat. Mm. Everyone that they're meant to be representing is now unrepresented.
They could nominate a replacement.
Well, yeah, but how? What, you're going to have a by-election over a bullying claim?
Maybe they happens. Have, like, an understudy at election time.
I like this.
They run on having an understudy or someone.
That's a good idea.
And they have to look exactly like them as well.
OK, and think exactly like them?
But don't forget, sometimes people, the understudy, will poison the principal so that they have their moment on stage.
Wow, you've worked in some really weird theatres.
I've been an understudy.